camera throw you, and please don't throw the camera because it's really expensive.
But I don't care. I strut right by with my tail in the air. Straight.
Anyway, we're all gonna have a lovely night. I was watching a documentary on the well, it was on yesterday, right? And I was watching it a couple of days ago, and it was on yesterday. It was a couple of days ago that I was watching this, right? Right, what it is, right? There's a television channel. What is called Yesterday, right?
VIZ comic was the third best-selling publication in the whole of the United Kingdom.
You see, the thing is,
clap. It's like being at the clinic, isn't it? Clap. Definitely clap. Anyway, clap. The success clap. Changer. I mean, well, not really, because you're still sitting here talking about tractors and shit jokes.
We didn't notice, actually. You noticed that when...
Did you go and buy a yacht when you made it, like, whatever?
Well, the first time I sort of became aware that the comic was getting popular was when I was walking home from town past the Civic Centre, and I saw some people lying on the grass reading the comic, and I'd never seen anyone in public, apart from in the Gosford Hotel, actually reading the comic.
I've seen it written in a bus stop, right, that your father sells his arse in the public box. That's what I've seen written with me own fucking eyes. Are ye gonna deny it? 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 Answer on a scale of 1 to 5, where 1 is equal to fucking listen to ye, your father shit himself in Morrison's in the flute aisle, and where 5 is equal to your mom. Sorry? 2. Lovely. Okay, thank you very much.
No, I'll tell you a story about Jimmy Nail. He turned up at the office one day, and my secretary rang up and she said, Jimmy Nail is in reception. And
wait a minute, it's turned into a Jeremy Kyle show. What's going on here? It's like Viz.
Yeah, I got a phone
on stage.
Phone call from his secretary. He said, Jimmy Nail's in reception. He's got a great... I don't know what to do. She said, he's bleeding. There's a great big cut on his head and he's bleeding. And I thought, Jesus. And I just assumed, because Jimmy Nail had a reputation for being a bit of a rough sort of person, that he would have had a street fight and, like, crawled into our office, like, to save himself. And then I went down, and sure enough, he was sat there relaxing in a chair with a great big gash in his head and all blood down there. And I looked at him all worried, and he said, "Don't worry about this," he said. "This is just theatrical makeup, because I've just banged my head on the bottom of a trawler," because he was being Spender at something, and he'd swum under the sea to do something, and then he'd come up and banged his head on a trawler. That's why he had a gash on his head. I was on a metro train once, travelling out of town, and I saw two kids. Well, there was two kids sitting opposite each other, and their dads were sat next to them, and I was, like, standing nearby. And the two kids started, like, kicking each other. They were a bit rough-looking, and they started kicking each other, and I was like, and I thought, it's about time one of these parents said something and stopped them. And then one of the parents, he leaned towards his kid, and he said, "Go on, son, I'm right behind you." And that was kind of the inspiration for bacon.
So, first of all, favourite top tips, one each.
Favourite top tip, well, my least favourite top tip would be, if you're ever late for an aeroplane, ring the airport and say there's a bomb on board and they'll hold it up.
Why is that? Why?
Well, that was because we got in trouble for it off the police, and I had to go to New Scotland Yard and be interrogated by the anti-terrorist branch. And we were told we weren't to do that again. I got an official caution. One day we had a pile of about 500 Shaken Stevens records in the corner of the room, which someone had sent us as a competition prize. And it had Shaky's face on it, and Doreen was, like, looking at his face, and she said to Stevie, who was sitting at the reception desk, she says, "My, I wouldn't mind having his slippers under me bed." And Stevie said, "Doreen, are you not a bit old for that sort of thing?" And Doreen said, "Hey, there's no fucking dust on my twat." Which she meant in all sincerity.
On a normal night, What I do is I go out and I fucking swallow like, I don't know, like fucking 5, 10, 20, 200, 3,000, 20 million pints, gallons of fucking lager, strong lager, like whiskey, fucking with 50 million fucking gallons of fucking whiskey, petrol, like fucking about fucking 2,000 fucking million gallons of fucking aircraft fuel, right? Then, fucking sulfuric acid, right? And I fucking drink it with me eyes, right? And I fucking, oh, anyway, like, right? That's normal, right? That'll be like a Tuesday.
And I got get stuck.